Everyone, and welcome back to my studio. If you follow my channel already for a while, then you know that there exists already one video with exactly the same title, Plastic Surgery for Operetta. It was made, of course, probably 2 years ago or something like this, really long ago. In that video, I took an operetta doll and I did approximately the same what I've done to Brad's doll a couple of weeks ago. I've basically cut off and sanded off the rubber on her face to get rid of the scars on one half of her face. And then I've got really lots of comments from people who were saying, you should have just filled it in with clay and that's it. So it's been already 2 years later and I still keep thinking if that kind of plastic surgery, if that advice was really useful and possible. So today we're going to test it finally. So here is our operetta doll, everything is very regular, here she has scars on her face and here also on her body. So let's try a completely new plastic surgery method today. Before we're busy more like with conservative surgery, with really cutting and sanding, then today we're going to work more with fillers in some way, filling stuff in. So, but first of all, I need to remove her outfit and cut her hair as short as I can. And now let's warm this head up with a hair dryer to make it soft and to be able to take it off from the body and also to melt the glue inside of the head to be able to remove the rest of the hair. See, now I can remove the head without breaking anything down. And then with my tweezers, I'm removing the rest of the hair from the inside of the head. And now I'm going to remove her makeup using pure acetone, like always. And by the way, we will still need this bottle of acetone today because I'm going to start the transformation with shrinking this doll's head in acetone. And I'm not really doing it to make this doll's head smaller and the whole doll more proportional because of this. But I'm going to do it to make this doll's head harder. Because look, I think if I take, for example, now some epoxy sculpt or an air dry clay and fill in all these scars on her face, and then I will, for example, reroute her head or even put the head back together to the body. I'm going to squeeze this soft head and all our clay, all our sculpt is going to just fall out and it's going to be over and very disappointing in the end. But after shrinking those heads in acetone for 48 hours, they become really hard. Look, I have here one from another project. You can see how much smaller it is. And also, it's really hard, you cannot really squeeze, it's plastic, like, it sounds like plastic. And this is exactly what I'm going to reach. I want to have this plastic, hard, unsqueezable, unpushable doll head. So for this I'm going to take a jar, fill it in with pure acetone, I will let this doll's head in for 48 hours. The jar must be bigger than the doll's head, because after a couple of hours it's going to become really big, and if the jar is too small, then the sides of the jar are going to squeeze to push this very fragile, very big doll's head, and it might crack and there might be some damage happening. So the jar must be quite big, there must be enough free space in it. Okay, let's wait. And here we are 48 hours later, and let's take a look at what has happened to the doll's head. It has become much bigger, of course. You see, it just fits the jar. So let's get it out on there. Acetone. Wait. Yes, here we are. You see, it's become really huge. Here it is next to some regular Monster High doll's head. You see, it's for sure 2 times bigger, if not 2.5. And it's also very, very, very soft. It's really... It's really like some, I don't know, very, very soft rubber, even like some jelly silicone, something like this. You see, it's really moving like some jellyfish. Now I'm going to let this head dry again for another 48 hours, and then we'll see what will happen again. And this is how her face looks a couple of days later. Actually, I waited a little bit longer than 48 hours to be sure that the hardening and the shrinking are over, because, you know, it would be quite painful if I would fill in all the scars with epoxy sculpt, and then in 3 days the head would shrink another 0.5 millimeter and all this stuff would just fall out, you know. So now I'm sure that the process is finished. You see, it's very hard, it feels more plastic, it seriously shrinked. I cannot really, you know, deform it by squeezing it with my fingers. So I think I'm ready to start the plastic surgery. I will need my gloves, of course, and the epoxy sculpt. I'm mixing the part A with the part B, and then I'm filling in all the scars on her face. Okay, the face looks good to me, but she also has the same marks on her body. So first of all, I'm going to remove the face. It's going to dry now for 24 hours. And her body I'm going to sand first with nail buffers to remove this glossy top. Then the epoxy sculpt is going to stick better to her, to the surface. And then I'm going to clean it with an acetone-free nail polish remover. And now let's fill in these marks using the same epoxy sculpt. The next day, when the epoxy sculpt gets completely hard, I'm going to take my nail buffers, a piece of some very, very fine sanding paper, and I'm going to sand her face, especially this sculpted part, the sculpted half of it, to be sure that there is no, like, difference on the surface, that there is no, like, a bump between her original face and the part that we've sculpted. After this, I'm going to cover the head and the body with a couple of layers of acrylic paint using my airbrush to cover up this color difference between the original skin tone and the sculpted areas. And this is how her face looks after applying a couple of layers of acrylics. Yeah, pretty smooth, I think. So now I'm going to spray it with 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant to be able, you know, to draw on this surface to make it matte. And then we're going to start. And first of all, I'm going to give her a pair of eyes. Then she needs eyebrows, of course. Then I draw the nostrils. And after this, I can start blushing her face. I want to keep her skin tone very soft, very gentle, very natural, so I'm going to use these very soft and natural colors pastels today. The last layer I've protected with Mr. Super Clear sealant, and now I'm going to add a touch of pink pastels to her face because I want her to have a little bit like pinkish subtone. And now I'm going to take the same pencil I've used to sketch her eyes and eyebrows, and I'm going to draw deeper shadows around her eyes, on her nose, and then it will be very important to blend these pencils really, really, really good. And to make the blending absolutely perfect, I'm still going to add a touch of pink pastels to all the transitions areas between the shadows and the highlighted parts. Okay, now let's draw her eyes more detailed. I know, it's maybe not very smart and not completely logic that I've already sketched the irises and now I'm going to cover them completely with a couple of layers of white pencil. But you know, I kinda like this technique now. I've tried it first a couple of weeks ago on Marilyn Monroe doll because she had like two small eyes and it just worked better. And then I repeated it again a week ago in my Taurus doll. So I really love this new technique and I'm going to do it again today. Let's also make her eyebrows more realistic by adding more hair. And then I'm going to draw the line between her lips and also the corners of her lips. To her lips I'm going to apply a touch of darker pink pastels and then I'm going to blend it nicely. Then I add grey shadows to the eyeballs to make them look round. And then I protect this doll's face with another layer of Mr. Super Clear Sealant. Now it's time to take a light pencil and draw the highlights. I start like always around her eyes, making the eyelids more realistic. I also make a little bit lighter the middle of the forehead. And then I also add reflections to her nose and to the lips. And what do we need to do now? Of course, we need to take a Q-tip and we need to blend this pencil really nicely. And now I think we can finally draw the irises, and this time I'm going to give her gorgeous blue eyes. I've repeated this layer twice again to get the very best coverage of the pencils, but now her eyes look pretty crazy, you know? And to solve it, we will have to add highlights to the bottom part of the irises and to add shadows to the upper part, where you get the shadows from the eyelids and from the eyelashes. And then I'm also going to add the bottom eyelashes and the black eyeliner. Okay, her face looks really good now, I think, and what I still want to do, I want to add the brightest highlights using this white acrylic paint. And you know what? I think I still want to add a touch of silver acrylic paint to her eyelids. And then I still need to blush her body using exactly the same set of pastels. And now, guys, we had to time travel a little bit because I've started to work on this doll in the end of March, but because of all this head shrinking and hardening and drying of this epoxy sculpt, I didn't manage to finish this doll before leaving on holidays in the end of April. And that's why now I'm back to Belgium 2 weeks later, and now we're going to continue working on this doll. There are actually just a couple of small details left. And first of all, I'm going to make a wig for this doll, and I'm going to use this absolutely snow white blonde hair in such a weft. This kind of hair I buy from AliExpress online, and I'm going to use my regular wig making technique. And first of all, I'm going to wrap this doll face with a couple of layers of some regular thin kitchen plastic, then I will protect it with a couple of layers of tape, and then we're going to attach this hair using hot glue. Then I'm going to make this part on top of her head flat using my hair dryer. And after this, I'm going to give her a bunch of curls. So now I can remove all this protection and the tape. We can also trim the sides here a little bit to make it look perfect. And you see, in the end we've got a perfect wig cap. It's very strong, it's very neat, and it fits perfectly our doll because it's made especially for her. So now I can actually connect the head and the body back together. And there is another tiny detail that I always forget till the very end. Look, guys, we have shrunk this doll's head. It has become smaller, and it means this hole in her head for the neck has also become smaller, and there is just no way for us right now to connect the head and the body back together like this. So it means I'm going to take my Dremel tool and I'm going to make this hole a little bit bigger to be able to connect the head and the body. Okay, now I'm going to attach the false lashes, add glossy varnish to her eyes and lips, and then we're going to talk about her outfit. According to the original Monster High story, Operetta is a daughter of the Phantom of the Opera. And honestly, I kinda like this concept, so today I'm going to follow this legend. And that's why I've asked my mom to create some dress that would fit a real opera diva. You know, something really gorgeous that she would be able to wear for an opening night, for example, at the opera house or something like this. And my mom has created this gorgeous silver dress. You see, it's closing like this at the back. And also this dusty pink mantle. So now I think I'm going to put it all together in our doll, and then we will take a look at the end result pictures. So, and this is my doll. Honestly, I've already forgotten that we have modified her face, that it was actually a plastic surgery video today. Because the last days I worked on this doll, I've actually just repainted her like usually, and I didn't even think about her face being changed like this. And this is probably the main sign of a successful plastic surgery, when you have quite quickly forgotten about some possible imperfections and about the steps you have taken to solve it. You know, the best plastic surgery looks like no plastic surgery, and that's why I can definitely call this transformation successful. Anyway, was it really necessary to hide the scars? Not of course, because they are part of her personality, but you know, it was very interesting to see how she would look without them, and also to try another method to get rid of the scars. And what do you think about this makeover? Which operetta do you like most? The original one? The one with her scars sanded off like in my first repaint? Or with the scars filled in with clay like today? Let's discuss it in the comments. And this doll will be like always for sale on eBay, and the link you can find in the description box. So guys, it was my doll transformation of the week. I really hope you enjoyed it, and if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, because the next week, Friday, we're going to do really something very special, because I have a huge box with new art supplies waiting right here. I'm going to start right now, I think. And I'm also going to repaint a very special, huge, almost human size doll. So if you don't want to miss these videos, please subscribe to my channel, and I will see you already very soon, next week, Friday. Love you guys. Have fun this weekend. Bye.